Welcome to KU Pathshala, a novel initiative of the University of Kerala to archive educative videos. Cliff is taking part in this venture wherein we are exposing the instruments being housed in the Cliff campus for the benefit of people who want to use the facility for their research purposes. The facility is managed by qualified technicians, highly trained, as well that governed or managed by faculty who are all experts in the field. The idea behind housing all the instruments under one roof is that not only that you will be able to use the instrument, but also get the feel of how exactly an instrument is functioning. For that matter, we are encouraging people to come to Cliff while their samples are analyzed so that they will be able to understand how the instrument is functioning to get the desired results. We have qualified faculty as well as outside experts who will be speaking during the video filming on the application value of each instrument being housed in this. The central instrumentation facility, which is being housed in the Karyottam campus, has got about 21 equipments, high-end equipments, being supported by different organizations in the country. I'm not going to the details of the functioning of the instrument as is going to be demonstrated in the videos. So I welcome you to view the videos, and straight away we see the videos about the functioning of the instruments which are housed in the Cliff campus. Thank you very much.
Hello all, myself Dr. Sunish CV, Assistant Professor at the Department of Chemistry, University of Kerala. In this video, we would like to introduce the Quantachrome NovaTouch Gas Sorption Analyzer, which is installed in the Central Laboratory for Instrumentation and Facilitation, Cliff University of Kerala. The Gas Sorption Analyzer, which is popularly known as BET Surface Area Analyzer, is most commonly used to determine the specific surface area of powder, solid, granular materials. This instrument analyzes the single and multi-point surface area, thickness, pore area distribution, pore volume, and Langmuir surface area of porous materials. It is interesting to know how the instrument measures or analyzes these unique features of a sample. All these analyses are carried out on the basis of volume of gas adsorbed at a different relative pressures. The basic principle of adsorption measurement includes two major processes, degassing and analysis. First process involves the removal of volatile impurities like moisture, carbon dioxide, solvents, and other contaminants on the sample surface by purging with an inert gas while being heated. After the preparation of sample, it is evacuated and cooled to liquid nitrogen temperature, which is 77 Kelvin. Normally, nitrogen gas is used as the adsorbate in this analysis. The gas sorption starts from the low relative pressure. As the pressure is increased, the formation of monolayer surface coverage was observed, as shown in the part marked as capital A of the graph and schematic diagram. It happens at very low relative pressures of the order of 0.1. This portion of the graph is normally used for the calculation of BET surface area. Further increase of the relative pressure causes the formation of multi-layer as shown in marked as B. The layer formation continues as the relative pressure increases, and then we may observe the capillary condensation in mesopores, which is shown in C. When pressure approaches the saturation pressure, the pores are completely filled as represented in part D, and we can estimate the total pore volume. Basic components of the instruments include high sensitivity pressure transducers, microprocessor controlled degassing stations with heating mandrels, and analysis port includes coolant level sensor and Dewar flasks. A typical experiment generally requires 50 to 100 milligram of the sample. The sample is degassed at a particular temperature and time duration, which depends upon the nature of the material. After degassing, weight of the sample is noted for analysis. After the adsorption desorption analysis, the TouchWind software displays the sorption isotherm, BET plot, total pore volume, and a pore size distribution. The typical isotherm provides useful information about filling of pores in the sample by gas sorption. Large uptake of nitrogen at a low relative pressure indicates the filling of micropores. The linear portion of the curve represents the multilayer absorption of nitrogen on the surface, and the concave upward portion of the curve represents filling of the meso and macropores. An entire isotherm is needed for one to calculate the pore size distribution of the material. BET is the most widely used method for the determination of the surface area of the solid material, which involves the use of BET equation, and the BET equation requires a linear plot of 1 upon W into P0 by P minus 1 versus P by P0. Gas sorption analyzer can be used for many applications. They can be used in the characterization of heterogeneous catalysis. Many heterogeneous catalysis are a combination of an active phase, normally a zero valent metal, spread on in an inert support, typically a refractory oxide or carbon. This instrument helps to determine the physical properties of catalysts such as surface area, porosity, pore size distribution, and density. Gas sorption analysis also finds application in characterizing the surface area and porosity of solid materials in pharmaceutical industry. Surface area plays a major role in the purification, processing, blending, tableting, and packaging of pharmaceutical products. It also can impact the drug's useful shelf life, its dissolution rate, and bioavailability. The use of materials with well-defined pore sizes and high surface areas are often used in biochemical and pharmaceutical separation processes. Next one is the battery applications. This instrument helps in understanding and measuring pore structure of many materials used in the lithium-ion and other technology power systems, and also applicable for fuel cells. Another important area where the technique is used is environmental remediation applications, especially in carbon dioxide sequestration research. Nowadays, novel materials are synthesized to improve the efficiency of carbon dioxide removal from different sources. The effectiveness of the target applications can be evaluated by using carbon dioxide sorption analysis. Not only carbon dioxide, but gas sorption analysis also used in the characterization of many materials for removal of a wide variety of other pollutants. Sorption isotherms are useful to optimize the use of adsorbents for the removal of pollutants from aqueous solutions also. Thank you.
Hi, welcome everyone to a wonderful session about surface analysis. I am Vishnu P, Technical Officer, Central Laboratory for Instrumentation and Facilitation, University of Kerala. The CLIF is a new and exciting initiative with number of analytical instruments under various schemes. The center represents one of the largest commitments for research in the history of university. Surface area. Surface area is the means through which a solid interacts with its surroundings, especially liquids and gases. Surface area is created by division of particles, that is size reduction, and the generation of porosity. Surface area is destroyed by sintering, melting, and Ostwald ripening. Consistent and reliable surface area results depend upon proper preparation procedure. The most popular and time-tested method for the determination of the specific surface area of porous solids is that developed in 1938 by Brunner, Emmett, and Teller. The BET theory extends Lagmo's theory to account for multi-layer physical adsorption of gases on solid surfaces. Experiments consist of collecting adsorption isotherms of inert gases, that is nitrogen, argon, krypton, carbon dioxide, etc., at low relative pressures. The BET theory provides the number of gas molecules required to form an equivalent monolayer over the sample surface. Multiplying the number by the average cross-sectional area of the molecules yields the BET surface area of the sample. Specific BET surface area are calculated by dividing the BET area by the weight of the sample following its pre-treatment to clean its surface by removing pre-adsorbed molecules. The BET theory forms the basis of numerous international standardization test methods employed by modern research and quality control laboratories worldwide. In terms of BET analysis, the limitation in throughput is often sample preparation. The complete degassing of samples can often require several hours, while surface area measurements may require as little as a few minutes. This is the degassing chamber. The degassing chamber at which the gases, moisture, etc. are removed by evacuating the sample cell. We can load 4 samples at a time in this chamber. That is, in station 1 we can load 2 samples, 1, 2, and then in station 2 we can hold 2 samples, 1, 2. That is here, in station 1 front, station 1 rear, then station 2 front, station 2 rear. We can load 4 samples at the same time. This is the 9mm filled sample cell in which we are filling the sample. This is bulb type. We have bulb type as well as without bulb. The bulb type is for powder sample and without bulb type is for granules. This is the sample cell without bulb and we have 9mm glass fill rod. This glass fill is used in order to cover the sample cell. We have 2 cylinders attached with this instrument. One is helium and the other is nitrogen. The nitrogen is for adsorption and desorption and the helium is for void volume calculation. This is the dewar which is used to take the liquid nitrogen. The liquid nitrogen is supplied in the analysis chamber for constant temperature. Then we have a human interface display through which we can interact with instrument by setting the parameters, checking the status of the instrument, and each and every step in the analysis can be verified through this touch display. While we are talking about the pore size, as per IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, the pore size is classified into 3 categories: mesoporous, macroporous, and microporous. The microporous have pore size smaller than 2 nanometer, macroporous having pore size larger than 50 nanometer, and mesoporous having pore size between 2 to 50 nanometer. Initially, we want to measure the weight of the empty cell. For that, we have a 5-digit balance. Open the balance. Hold the cell. Wait for stabilization. After measurement, take the cell out. Then we have to fill the sample to this cell. For that, we have a funnel. Keep the funnel at the top of the cell. Then we have to fill the sample to the cell. Fill the sample through this funnel. This funnel will help the sample to go direct to the bottom portion of the sample cell. After filling the sample, we have to again take its weight. After stabilization, note the measurement and take the cell out. Now it is ready for degassing. Now we have filled the sample to the sample cell and taken its weight. Now we want to load the cell to the degassing chamber. Now we have connected the cell to the station 1. Then for heating, we have this mantle. We have to place the cell into the mantle. So just hold the cell and raise the mantle. We have a chain here, just hang this mantle in this chain. After that, close the chamber. Now it's ready for degassing.
Open Contacom TouchWin software. Initially, we want to connect the PC and software with the instrument. Click connect. The red display will change to green. So the connection is OK. Then check the status of the analysis stations and the degasser stations. They should be in idle. We are going to degas the sample. So click Nova Touch Heater Profiles. Clear the parameters shown. Then add the parameters as required. Target the temperature that we want to achieve. Rate the rate at which the temperature has to rise. And finally, the soak time, the time that the sample to be maintained in target temperature. After that, click send. Give a name for the parameter. And click OK. Now the file is sent to the instrument and we have to select the station and the parameter name and start the degassing.
Now the degassing is completed. Now we can open this degassing chamber and we have to remove this mantle and then detach the cell. The mantle is hanged with the help of this pin. We have to remove this pin. Loose the thread. Slowly take it out. This is the sample after degassing. Now we want to take the weight of this sample with this cell and then after that we want to connect this to the analysis chamber. This is a 9mm rod. Now we can put this into the sample cell. Now the sample cell is ready to connect to the analysis chamber. Now we can connect this. Before that, we want to remove this neural thread. Hold it here. You want to just tie the cell. If we tight it more, the tip will break. So we want to just tight it. The flask is filled with the liquid nitrogen. Around 75% of the flask is now filled with the liquid nitrogen. Now we want to load this flask to the analysis chamber. Open the analysis chamber. Then place the flask inside the chamber. Close the chamber.
Now we are going to analyze the sample. For that, click NovaTouch Analysis Parameters. See the active stations. Three are active. Untick all the three. Now it shows an error message. Then tick the appropriate station in which we loaded the sample for analysis. Check the common parameters. These are the common parameters for all the four stations. Select the evacuation crossover mode according to our sample, whether powder, fine powder, pellet, etc. Then go for the selected station and set the parameters one by one. Admin, give a name for the result file. And specify comments if any. And then click verify. OK. Then points. We have to give the adsorption and desorption points. We can give it manually or load the preset files. Here we go for 20 points for adsorption and 20 points for desorption. Analysis. Here we want to select the cell, that is the sample holder which we are using for analysis. Here we are using 9mm with rod, so select it. Reporting. Jump to adsorbate gas. Then check everything once more and click start. There shows two error messages in the station. Weight and sample ID not entered. So we have to enter the same and description if needed. We selected only station 1 so that rest of the stations are not active. Finally, press start. The analysis may take 3 to 5 hours as per our program. Initially, evacuation and pressure checks are done. It may take around 20 to 30 minutes for that. After that, race bath procedure will start. Now, the bath is rising slowly.
When the analysis is complete, an information label upload complete, data saved flashes on the screen, and after around 30 minutes the DEWA starts drop down automatically. Finally, an isotherm graph appears on the screen. Now we can look at some of the applications of BET. Carbon for rubber adsorbents, that is for water purification, and gas separation, inks, gas masks, laser printers and copiers. Catalyst for the fertilizer, automotive, petrochemical and fuel cell industries. Minerals such as clays, alumina, hydroxyapatite, phosphates, pigments, silica, zirconia, etc. used for abrasives, adsorbents, biomaterials, ceramics, cement, desiccants, filters, papers and paints. Organic materials for chromatography, adhesive, cosmetics, detergents, foodstuffs, explosives, ion exchange, resins, pharmaceuticals and plastics. Powdered metals and ferrites for batteries, pressure formed sintered products, electronics, magnetic tape and magnets. Other application related to bone, composite material, fibers, rigid forms, soil, sludge, slurries, suspensions, well, and many more. With this, we can wind up the session. Thank you.